Cooking up dope in the crock pot. We came from nothing to something, nigga. Hey. I don't try nobody to grip the trigger. Call up the gang and they come and get janked. Alright, alright. It's crack a lagging. Yeah, man. So, had that long day today on the bone phone. You know, try to keep shit in perspective. Keep on, you know, keep motherfuckers with something to think about as all this moves forward. You know what I'm saying? You don't want to move backwards. Stay in one place. If you feel you gotta move backwards, stay in one place. Or move back, make a leap forward. You know what I'm saying? Keep it real simple. But that's basically where, you know, that's where we at in a nutshell. You know what I'm saying? That's where all this at is in a nutshell. It ain't you feel me? You know what I'm saying? You feel me? So, you know, like I said, when you're putting your creativity to work, you know, make sure your platform is like a springboard, as you used to say back in the day, a jump off. So you can jump off or jump on and land on something solid that you can hold on to for a minute so you can figure out what your next step gonna be and work towards that, right? So the faster you can put your plan of action together and give certain things a time frame, you know, give things in life a time frame to where, okay, you're starting here, you want to move it to this, give it a time frame, and you know, as you're doing that back and forth, they say testing waters, but I'm gonna say like a bird building a nest. He only can carry so many twigs at one time. You know, they bring it, and then just back and forth, finding out what works. You know what I'm saying? Find out what works. What can you take over there? What not to take over there? You know what I'm saying? Even building your platform or building or doing whatever you want to do. You know, try to think what can you take over there? You know, me personally, plenty times I just get that mind frame, I get in that mind frame, I get that attitude. You just let me go on over there and see, because I should be able to gather some type of information that may help me get started or further what I'm trying to do. Now, I don't want to take all this time to be talking about how to, getting on platform. I don't want to get into all that, but there is a thing about repetition, about seeing and hearing something constantly for a specific amount of time, enough that you can get it, and if you can't do nothing with it, at least you got it. So when you come to that situation or that point, you might be able to reflect and use that. When you didn't, like, damn, I forgot, I didn't think about that, you can use that. So I don't want to spend a lot of time on that, because it, you know, it get repetitive to the point where it's not repetitive in a good way. Yeah, they say things become redundant, right? It becomes redundant. So so like I was saying on the bone phone, when you've been doing something for so long and you wanna, and it didn't turn out right and you want a fresh start, well, the thing about the fresh start or the next level, the next phase, not all the time you're going to be able to take all that over here, because what they say, you know, it might be a lot of negativity, a lot of uncertainty, a lot of different things that don't need to carry on, and that's what life. And see, so like I was saying, you know, folk come through and they be like, hey man, you know, this, that, and such, you know, bomb, bomb. Because see, we trying to move forward. We're not trying to dwindle in the past. And you know, that's all good, because sometimes, you know, people, like they said, if you don't know your past, you won't know your future. Okay, that's good too, but sometimes leaving that past open for viewers, for up and coming to see, it's a good thing, because they become cautionary tales. Now, if you take the cautionary tales out, that means your future should have nothing, no remnants of that past. So the up and coming, they bypass that and just get, they just move on to this. And it starts from that point. So then you can't get away from saying, if you don't know your past, you don't know your future. It's like, well, you don't have a past, you have a future. And that's what everybody wants to start at. You know, that's a reference point everybody would like to start at. But people, society, different things, found out that's hard to do, because people don't let a lot of things go, or you reflect retrospectively, or nostalgia. See, so that's a difficult thing to do. So what happens, it's on the individual. It's on the individual, the group, or whatever movement, to determine how much of that, learning from the past and know the future, how much of that is necessary. Can I just start at a future point and work towards that and go that way? That's going to all depend on the individual, because society is not geared, it's not designed, it's not set up for you to forget a past and bomb. And so you take a little kid, he gonna get hit with the past one way or the other. Now, processing it, taking it to heart and roll with it, that's a totally different thing. You see what I'm saying? So everything, you know, is all about decisions. It's all about how much time to spend, how much time to gorge. Like I use that word gorge. You know, I gorge a lot of content and different things. How much time you need to do that? How much you need to retain? You see what I'm saying? So when you're in school, that's how they want you to approach your books and your education. But education in the books is all a part of a past. See, that's the other side. It's all a part of a past. But they feel is that you need to know the past. Okay, but when you get in there, you learn in the past, and you start gorging and hitting the books, hitting the internet, getting your education on. Okay, see, that. And you know, depending on what they see, that's society's issue. That's a societal issue. Changing history, the different folk history. You see what I'm saying? That's a societal issue. And then here you come. Well, what are you going to grasp on to? 9 times out of 10, you grasp a hold of what you are comfortable, or what you've been seeing, what you've been hearing. You gravitate towards that. Right? You gravitate towards that because that's what you've been seeing. That's what you know. Right? So, asking a society to change is almost like asking the people to forget about their past.